I just don't know what we have to do to make these government interlopers happy. They tell us to make a safer cigarette. We do it, and then suddenly, that's not good enough.
Might as well be living in Russia.
Mm. Damn straight. You know, this morning I got a call from our competitors at Brown and Williamson, and they're getting sued by the federal government because of the health claims they made.
Yeah, we're aware of that, Mr. Garner. But you have to realize that through manipulation of the mass media, the public is under the impression that your cigarettes are linked to certain fatal diseases.
Manipulation of the media? Hell, that's what I pay you for. Our product is fine. I smoke them myself.
My granddad smoked them. Mm. He died at 95 years old. He was hit by a truck.
I understand. But our hands are tied. We're no longer allowed to advertise that Lucky Strikes are safe.
So what the hell are we going to do? We've already funded our own tobacco research center to put this whole rumor to rest.
And that's a very good start. But it may not affect sales. Don, I think maybe that's your cue.
Well, I have been thinking quite a bit about this. And I mean, you know, I'm a Lucky Strike man from way back, so.
I might have a solution. At Sterling Cooper, we've been pioneering the burgeoning field of research. And our analysis shows that the health risks associated with your product is not the end of the world. People get in their cars every day to go to work. And some of them die. Cars are dangerous. There's nothing you can do about it. You still have to get where you're going. Cigarettes are exactly the same. So why don't we simply say, so what if cigarettes are dangerous? You're a man. The world is dangerous. Smoke your cigarette. You still have to get where you're going.
That's very interesting. I mean, if cigarettes were dangerous, it would be interesting.
Except they aren't. Is that your slogan? You're gonna die anyway? Die with us?
Actually, it's a fairly well-established psychological principle that society has a death wish. And if we could just tap into that, the market potential is...
What the hell are you talking about? Are you insane? I'm not selling rifles here. I'm in the tobacco business. We're selling America. The Indians gave it to us for shit's sake.
Come on, Dad. Let's get out of here. The bright spot is, at least we know if we have this problem, everybody has this problem.
Gentlemen, before you leave, can I just say something?
I don't know, Don. Can you?
The Federal Trade Commission and Reader's Digest have done you a favor. They've let you know that any ad that brings up the concept of cigarettes and health together, well, it's just going to make people think of cancer.
Yes, and we're grateful to them.
But what Lee Jr. said is right. You can't make those health claims, neither can your competitors.
So, we got a lot of people not saying anything that sells cigarettes.
Not exactly. This is the greatest advertising opportunity since the invention of cereal. We have six identical companies making six identical products. We can say anything we want. How do you make your cigarettes?
I don't know.
Shame on. We breed insect repellent tobacco seeds, plant them in the North Carolina sunshine, grow it, cut it, cure it, toast it.
What? There you go. There you go.
But everybody else's tobacco is toasted.
No, everybody else's tobacco is poisonous. Lucky Strikes is toasted.
Well, gentlemen, I don't think I have to tell you what you just witnessed here.
think you do.
Advertising is based on one thing. Happiness. And you know what happiness is? Happiness is the smell of a new car. It's freedom from fear. It's a billboard on the side of the road that screams with reassurance that whatever you're doing, it's okay. You are okay.
It's toasted. I get it.